Okay, thank you, Latifa, and good morning to everybody. Let me first of all introduce quickly the project NAWAMED, that actually is the project that is hosting and organizing all these events. NAWAMED, that means a natural brand solution for domestic water reuse in Mediterranean country, involve five countries, in particular in Italy, there is the lead partner, Latina province, IRIDRA, ourselves, Euro-Mediterranean Center for the Sustainable Development located in Sicily. In Malta, we have Energy Water Agency. In Tunisia, for sure, the organizer, we are hosting this great event at the Center for Water Research and Technology, CERTE. In Jordan, University of Jordan Amman, and the American University of Beirut in Lebanon. The project duration is about 36 months. We are in the middle, and the project is financed by the NECBC MED program. Maybe you will have more information about the program from the next speaker, but just to tell you that involve 14 EU and partner countries and is based on four thematic objectives and 11 priorities. And in particular, NAWAMED has been financed under the water efficiency thematic objective and the priorities environmental protection, climate change adaptation and mitigation. In fact, NAWAMED, the main general objective of NAWAMED is to change the urban water management practice by means of the demonstration and the implementation of a natural-based solution applicable in a decentralized way in order to foster the use of non-conventional water at the urban level. In particular, we will develop many activities, we developed already, started to develop many activities that in particular can be listed here. We will implement at least 8 real scale Python installations around the country partners. We will involve decision makers and technicians in different, but also merging their during the participatory approach that we call the water tables in order to improve the capacity building, but also to try to foster the mainstreaming of this solution. So, after this first very quick information about NAWAMED, let me came back a little on the history of this word, natural-based solution, because we now, in this moment, we use this word. During the last year, the scientific world used these terms, natural-based solution, but actually is quite new. Why, for example, the first definition of the European Commission on the about natural-based solution is in 2015 and defined the natural-based solution as those solutions that are inspired and supported by nature, that are cost-effective and simultaneously provide environmental, socio-economic benefit and support also the resilience of the cities. And in a second step, added also the idea that this solution had to support the delivery of a range of ecosystem services. To understand better the connection between, for example, the role of natural-based solution, specifically on constructed wetland, that is our issues, to provide and sustain ecosystem service, you can read, for example, this scientific article that we synthesized in a news that you can find on the NAWAMED website, where co-written by IRIDRA, Fabio Masi and Anacleto Rizzo, put together and make clear the role of the natural-based solution to support the ecosystem services approach. You can find from this slide to the end all the reference of the link to the article or news that I will mention on the right corner of my slides. As Fabio already underlined in a more technical way, what means simultaneously? That's in particular the green wall, it's clear that also if NAWAMED, for example, we are proposing the installation of a green wall for treating and reusing grey water, we need also to communicate to our audience that contemporary there are other benefits. And for example, a green wall improves aesthetic, regulatory relative temperature and enhance biodiversity and quality and air quality. It's important also to communicate these simultaneously benefit. But let's take a step back. In a recent article of USN, July 2020, this article starts with this reflection that for most of the 20th century, the environmental related issues were considered an obstacle. During the last 20 years, the growing scientific consensus make clearer that nature is essential for human existence and good quality of life. We can find, for example, a news of these days that the UN, United Nations and Department of Economic and Social Affairs is modifying the framework to go behind the gross domestic product, including the nature as an added value to measure the natural capital and to make clear the contribution of nature to our prosperity. So it's something that also not only is growing up during these 15-20 years, but it's considered now really necessary and urgent after or during unlikely this pandemic period. Essential also to make this green and use in an efficient way the recovery funds that Europe is putting in place. But if we need to understand the process, the first time 20 years ago, more or less, we used for the first time the term natural best solution. But until the 2015, so until the moment that European Commission financed and put natural gas solution at core of EU research and innovation program, the number of articles, for example, was not so much. And since 2015, this number grew up, as you can see, and as you can better read in the report of some experts of the European Commission about the state of art in the EU-funded project about natural gas solution. So now is clear that natural gas solution in this moment are visible and is clear and understood by everybody that is an opportunity. However, in the same report, the experts underline that they cannot yet be classed as a routine business. And as we know, this is a risk. So, from one side, we need smart solution, smart engineering solution, and it's how Fabio explained that we have a range of smart engineering solution. For example, the constructed wetland from the handbook Think Nature about natural based solution, again, is considered one of these. They are considered a good example of innovative engineered natural based solution. About this, I would like a dubs, because what we mean for innovative? If we think that the constructed wetlands are innovative system, if I open the website of IRIDRA, I found that the first draft of the constructed wetland is about 30 years ago. So maybe it's not the system, the measure. So can be the use of non-conventional water. Later, how Fabio told, if I think to my grandfather, or this is a play of my son that 3 years old, thinking to bring water on the house, just connect the roof to take water, because for a child, the water came from the novel. So it's not the year the innovation. So maybe we have to think that when Europe ask us to innovating our approach with cities, with nature, we think other things. So not just measure, not just the solution, but maybe is asking us to rethink the pathway, because population is growing up, citizens are growing up in the city. So maybe we need to supply child health service. So it's true that we are talking about constructed wetland, but also we are talking about green wall, to use the same system, but in a smaller space. But at the same time, we need also to support, to supply system to enhance the physical and mental well-being of citizens. It's something that is more and more urgent. And in this period, again, with the pandemic period, it's really clear. So we need an holistic approach to stress the fact, as European Commission defined, the simultaneously environmental, social, economic benefit. And how I am using some slides as Fabio, because are from IRIDRA, we need to change the approach on the system. So shift from the linear approach, as Fabio told, to the circular approach. So we cannot just propose a simple solution, a simple measure, a technical measure, smart or not, but we need to include all these solutions in a more holistic and a wider approach to make all the system more circular, something that, how Fabio underlined already, is more familiar for the waste manager and less familiar in a municipality, for the public authorities, related to the water management. So it's clear that all these aspects are now an opportunity. Now, in this moment, more than other period on the past. But again, the question and the challenge is to shift them from niche to mainstream. And for example, a project, Horizon 2020 project, NaturVision, proposed to face this problem, to reach the goal, an integrated approach. So many key factors can make possible to reach the goal. Rethinking water in cities is the first, but new partnership, funding arrangements, new way of working, enhanced public participation, increased collaboration, and long-term city planning. In particular, I want to stress the fact that the new partnership, this issue is really multi-level and multidisciplinary, and we need to renovate also the idea of stakeholder participation that we had in the past talking about water management. Because the challenges are multiple, and here in this, or again in the handbook of Think Nature on nature-based solution, you can find a description of the different challenges that a project, the one to approach on nature-based solution and water management, need to face. Because there is a problem, a lack of different knowledge regarding design, implementing, and maintaining nature-based solution, and for example, the next days and our proposition with ET technical workshop, and so the case studies, the working group is facing this lack of understanding, deep understanding among key actors, deficiency of skills and experience, lack of know-how and successful experience, lack of ready to use technology and ready to apply scientific results and concepts. That is something that sometimes stop a little the decision makers to start a process, and insufficient follow-up monitoring of implemented nature-based solution. Some of these challenges, for example, are debated in this article, scientific article, again, Fabio Masi and Acreto Rizzo from IRIDRA are co-writer, that you can read to try to understand if, for example, nature-based solution appropriate for rainwater treatment, if we have enough available information to guide designers for the full scale application of nature-based solution, again for rainwater treatment, and if is it possible to assess the environmental benefit. So reading this article, you can find that we understand how we answer already to this challenge. Obviously, as always, I will add, we are always, again, the financial administrative barriers. This time, taking account that the nature-based solutions are often more cost-effective than traditional green infrastructure alternatives, the barriers to their implementation are often more complex. And why? This is linked to the lack of education, of knowledge of the technician about this issue. And this lack of knowledge will stop also the, will make slower also the mainstreaming of this solution into the urban policies. We discussed and synthesized during this interview to Dr. Cipolletta an article, a scientific article about these issues to Dr. Cipolletta that is working for Idrusa, and they studied how to face this kind of institutional fragmentation and legislative bottlenecks. That is clear, it's important that we need to foster the socioeconomic benefit, and so the mainstreaming of this solution, it's clear also at European level, and this policy brief that is just being published this month mentioned many possible solutions and some case studies, and it's good that Idrusa is one of these case studies that can be support the implementation of this solution at local level. So just to go to the toward the end of this presentation. There was a mood board during this year that was think globally and act locally. Now we need to think nature and act locally in the same way. So what we can do both? So we need a few key concepts, that is cooperation, and for example, Think Nature created this nature-based solutions cooperation manifesto just to guide cities to adopt nature-based solution, and many project research projects are already involved and they are interested. I propose this reading and to check this manifesto and this website, because you can discover many interesting results of all this project. And you have to networking, because we need to maximize the impact and the spread of nature-based solution. In this case, you can find this dedicated network dedicated this platform to maximize the impact of the results. And finally, I found this very interesting, for my opinion, platform to connect the natural enterprises, because this novel marketplace aims to directly connect increasing global market demand for nature-based solution, because if we are foster this issue, we are foster the demand with supply that this moment maybe is not able to supply all the solution that are required. So the conclusion is that is an opportunity also because is a simple concept that are more understandable also for non-specialist technician. We need to foster and bring together different sector and stakeholders, because otherwise the risk that the nature-based solution, again, as in the past other terminology, will remain a vague term without operational rigor is a risk. You can find many of my references to the web page on the European Commission nature-based solution. Otherwise, you can ask to us. We are NAWAMED, because NAWAMED is made by people that are working on the issues. And so we invite you to invest with us in non-conventional water use and investing in nature-based solution. You can follow us on the website, on Twitter, on Facebook, or also subscribing the newsletter. For sure, you can write also to me for any issue and question. Thank you very much.